Next up, we are taking you into Pikesville High School to experience all the exciting things happening here. Award-winning educator and technology chair, Scott Nichols, will get us up to speed. Come on, let's go find Scott. Thank you for having us here today, Scott. So tell us, what exactly goes on in this classroom?
We run a program at Pikesville High School, engineering program called Project Lead the Way. It's a 5-course program, and we allow every student the option to take the courses. And basically, they start out in ninth grade, and they learn a little bit about technical drawing and 3D software. And then throughout the 4 years and 5 courses, they learn about electrical engineering, mechanical, civil. We specialize in aerospace engineering.
And now we're gonna go find one of the students and see what they're doing in the lab. Come on. So we're here with Eli Facto, and he's working on some amazing things as it pertains to 3D imaging. So tell us about what's going on here, Eli.
Well, there are millions of people in resource-poor areas that lack medical services, and injuries that we take for granted here, I say take for granted so that we take the treatment for granted, like a broken arm, they don't have. So you break your arm in an area where you can't get a cast, and it might become a permanent issue. So 3D printed casts exist, but they're hard to make. It takes someone who knows 3D software like Autodesk to build one. So what I've done is I've created a 3D model of a cast and a procedure so that anyone could design and build one without having any sort of advanced training. And I've gone through about 12 models. I found a design that's really robust, but it's open. So if you've ever broken your arm and felt the humidity under a cast, it's not super pleasant. So it's an open design, doesn't collect humidity. You can see when a patient's arm begins to swell, so you can make a new cast.
No, we're not about to play a game of tennis, but it's very interesting what Chad's working on. So I'm gonna let him tell you a little bit more about what's going on here with this tennis racket.
Yeah, so the main problem with tennis rackets is when they break, the string only breaks in one point, right? But you end up replacing the whole racket, so it's actually this much string. All of this, it's about 40 feet of string going into this one racket. So when it breaks, instead of replacing an amount of string that's like this long, which is like 13 inches, you end up replacing the whole string. So it's a lot of wasted money. And also because stringing rackets is so hard to do by yourself, you have to bring it to a specialized person. And so then there's waiting time. So you you end up having a replacement racket. And so that's $200 extra that you're wasting too. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So actually, so our prototype for our detachable strings, we're hoping that people can do it themselves. That way they don't have to go bring it somewhere to get restrung. So our prototype right now consists of the strings basically attached to a peg. So when you insert it in, it clips, it expands so that way you can't pull it back out. So it kind of looks like this. Here, if you want to see it, yeah. So that's what this animation is showing. It's just showing it moving in and out.
Wow, that's really cool. So we're here now with Aaliyah and Logan. Our design is specific in hospital settings where you would have a sensor that is on the patient that we're going to create a 3D model cast for the patient to wear. This will send an alarm or text to the nurse when the patient sits up or above 90 degrees to let them know that they might be at risk for a fall. So this decreases the response time that the nurse will need to get to the patient to make sure that they are as safe as possible.
And we're here with Carson today on Next Up Baltimore County. Welcome, Carson.
Hello.
Hi. So I know that a lot of times during the day, my phone, I see it going down as far as the battery power, and it sounds to me like you're working on something that can help eliminate that?
Here we have a model of what it's going to look like, and this integrated circuit is going to be inserted into this mobile cell phone charger, and it makes it so that the batteries that are inserted here are able to be the battery power is able to be converted into cell phone charge power through this this USB drive port. So you can hook up any cell phone charger to this USB drive, and then you can instantly plug it into your phone and it'll work with 98% efficiency.
So Scott, we've seen some really cool things going on with the students and their projects. Could you tell us, I'm just curious, what happens next with the project?
So what we'll do at the end of the year, so they've been working on these projects for a whole year. At the end of the year, part of the project is building a business plan and developing a pitch and a business proposal and all that good stuff. So at the end of the year, we'll have a board of professionals from industry come in you know, to the school, and they'll present their projects and defend any questions that the professionals have. You know, any questions they have or any, you know, problems they have with the design, they'll defend it, why they did it that way. And take the feedback and then decide, you know, do we want to move forward with it?
And by moving forward?
So rarely does it happen, but in some cases, we've had high school projects in the Project Lead the Way, like nationwide, that have, you know, gone on and gotten a provisional patent and then moved forward with maybe being produced by some company. So if they're interested in doing that, they can get a provisional patent for $70 or $80, and then they have a year without documentation to get outside resources to work towards the full patent that needs to be documented.
Well, I'm very excited about what I saw today. So hopefully we'll be seeing a lot of these things in the near future that we can use, huh?
I hope so.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us today at Pikesville High School for Next Up Baltimore County.